Ma'am, you are live now.
Thank you, Saloni ma'am, for telling me. Good afternoon, everyone, and I welcome you on the celebration of 26th National Reading Day. We Sapiens are going to inaugurate the online book club of our school today. I would like to quote here the famous lines written by Jim Rohn. Reading is essential for those who seek to rise above the ordinary. We all know that reading is very important for all of us because it develops our mind and gives us excessive knowledge and lessons of life. It helps us understand the world around us better. It keeps our mind active and enhances our creative ability. There is a never-ending list of the benefits of reading. Reading improves our vocabulary and develops our communication skills. Reading a good book takes us into a new world and helps us relieve our day-to-day stress. It has several positive effects on our mind. It takes us to the world of imagination and enhances our creativity. It helps us explore life from different perspectives. Books are known to be our best friends for a reason. So it is very important to develop a good reading habit. You all must have heard the famous lines written by Margaret Fuller. Today a reader, tomorrow a leader. We Sapiens truly believe in the world of books. And that is why the school has a well-stocked library with large collection of books, almost over 7,000. Books are available on all subjects. Several storybooks, novels, and self-learning books have also been kept for the students' use. The library is a home of encyclopedias and reference material. But due to this pandemic time, our library is missing its readers. But thanks to our wonderful students and their ideas, one of our students, Master Purvang Kaushik, has taken the initiative and came up with the idea of a book club, which he will be handling online. Today, he will be telling us about the functioning of the book club and all the necessary details related to it. Therefore, by not wasting any more time, I would like to welcome our proposer of the book club, Master Purvang Kaushik. Over to you, Purvang. The platform is open for you. Take your time and communicate your ideas.
Purvang?
Yes,
ma'am. Switch on your camera.
It's on, ma'am.
You are not visible actually. Yeah, just a minute. Okay, Purvang, you are live now.
Thank you, Sangeeta ma'am, for the warm welcome. As Sangeeta ma'am explained, today we have gathered here to talk about the newly proposed book club, the SAPS book club. Now, according to me, a book club is a place where stories are honored, revered, cherished, hallowed, and read, retold, reread, and a bunch of people come together, have some fun, and in the process, learn a lot of things. According to me, a book club is a place that can be tantamount to a temple or a place where people learn and people develop newer perspectives and widen their horizons. According to me, a book club is one of the most important things that we can have an institution. And hence, I propose to you the book club that we are going to start with from Monday. Now, the book club that we are going to start expects all the members to read a book chosen by us. For the very first month, we have chosen the book and the genre. We expect you to read the book every single month. And at the end of the month, we will hold a discussion which will be held on the last working Saturday of the said month. Now, the discussion will include basic questions, basic open-ended questions that will ask you about your individualized experience with reading the books. And as we know, that stories are very individualistic, which is to say that each and every single individual will have a different lesson from each and every single story that they will read. What I might have learned is going to be different from what you might have learned. So we at this book club are interested in knowing your perspective, what you have learned from the story, and what are your lessons. And we'll be highly obliged to actually host you and learn from you. Now, how will the book club work? Basically, the questions, sharing your opinions, of course, is voluntary. It's optional, but yet is highly suggested. Otherwise, we would lose the essence of the book club. The book club operates on the very idea that a bunch of people will come together, they'll cotton on books, they'll share the love of reading with each other, and then they will share their opinions on the read books, on the said stories, in the form of written reviews or via discussions, spoken discussions. So I highly recommend you people joining, people interested, to actually participate in the discussions, actively participate in the discussions. Now, we've also proposed that the book with the best reviews, at the end of the year, we're going to have a lot of reviews coming in. And after reading a bunch of books, we will decide the book with the best reviews. We will get to know about the book with the best reviews. And we will, as a group of readers, bibliophiles, we will compound our short reviews, which is to say we will compound small statements given on the books that will be read, and we'll compound them together, we'll coalesce them together tersely, and it might even be shared with the people who are not a part of the book club in order to encourage them to read more or join the book club. Now, For the proposed book club, the choice for the books, as I told you before, the genre has been chosen by us for the first month, as we're just starting off, as we've just taken off. We don't know the demographic. We don't know the number of people who will be joining in. We don't know the kind of people who will be joining in. We don't know the level at which you have been reading. We don't know the kind of books that you like. So for the first month, we have taken the cogency of deciding the books for you. Of course, we will give you an option, but the genre has been decided already. But from here on, after the first month, after the discussion for the first month happens, we will give you the opportunity to decide the genre as well. Now, we've also decided that in order to accommodate for each and every single person's needs and tastes, different members might have different reading tastes, we will give, on certain months, we will choose random members, and aleatorily chosen members will be given the chance to read the book of their choice and make other members read the book of their choice, which is to say they will be given the opportunity to choose the book for the month or the genre if they're not sure about the book. The genre as in the category. Now, how will the discussions happen? For the book club, jo book club humne propose kiya hai, usme we have decided that we will create a separate team. A separate team will be created for all the members who join in or all the people interested. But for joining in, you will have to fill the forms. A form has already been sent to the general channel of the teams of your classes. So if you have seen the form and if you fill the form, then you will be already included in the team. You're automatically enrolled and you will be given the membership. The people who have agreed, the people who have conceded to join the club will be added to the team on Microsoft Teams. And on the team itself, the PDFs of the book in the form of ebook, of course, will be sent to the people free of cost, and they will be able to read the book. Not only will the PDF of the book that has been chosen for the month be sent, but also all the books that have been shortlisted for the month, all the books that were up for polling will be sent so that anybody who's interested in reading two books or more can read them. Now, the concept basically
talks about people joining in. Anybody joining in can join with people that they know. But the catch being that you should include somebody that who lives with you or somebody that you can accommodate into the discussions with the same ID. We will not be able to allot different team IDs to different members. So the reading buddies or the people that you would be reading your books with should be able to join the discussion with the same team's ID as you. And the reading buddy will be able to read the book of the month with you, and they can join the discussions. They will be actively involved in the discussions, and The option is open for both teachers and students, any teacher or student who wishes to join the month. Now the book of the month for July, we have already, included the genre. The theme and the genre or the category
for this month is mythological retellings. This month ki jo category hai, that is mythological retellings, which is to say that a twist on mythology. There are certain myths that have been told by various philosophers. There are myths that have been passed on from generations to generations. They're heirlooms. Those myths that have been passed on from generation to generation, there are stories that have been told. Now, the very genre of mythological retelling is a twist on that. It's a modern day retelling of myths. It's a modern day retelling of ancient stories from the perspective of people living in today's day and age, people living in the present. So, हमारी choices इस month के लिए चार हैं. We have decided चार book हमने decide करी हैं. And the first book that we have is Circe by Madeline Miller. The second book that we have is Norse Mythology by Neil Gaiman. The third one is A Palace of Illusions by Chitra Banerjee Devakoti. And the fourth one is A Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. Now, if you are interested, I enjoin you to fill the form. And in the form itself, you will see these four books mentioned and you can poll for them. The book that will get, that will muster the majority, that will muster the majority's votes will be read by the book club at the end of the month of July, which is to say that the discussion will happen around 20th July, but the actual date, the exact date, precise date will be intimated to you soon after this event, after it's been decided. The first book that I talk about now, the first book that has been chosen is The Palace of Illusions. Now, again, it's a reimagining of the world famous Indian epic, the Mahabharata. We all know about the Mahabharata. It is something that has been passed on to us by our parents. It's a story full of lessons. But the twist in this book, the twist in this modern day retelling of the Mahabharata by Chitra Banerjee Devakoti is that the novel has been written from the perspective of Draupadi. It has been written from the perspective of Panchali, and it talks about her life as a princess. And she is the character who will carry the book forward, which is to say that the narrator, the original narrator, has been scrapped off. And a side character, or rather very side character, or rather neglected character, Draupadi, has been made the narrator of the book. And she will talk about the epic of Mahabharata from her perspective, which is to say how she looked at it. It's a feminist retelling, as it's a female-centered book. Draupadi will be telling the story. She will be carrying the story forward. She'll be giving you an account of all the events happening. Now, the second book that I'm going to talk about is Norse Mythology. Norse Mythology by Neil Gaiman is not necessarily a fiction book. It can be called a non-fiction book. It can be called a children's book, even a children's book. Some people even like to call it a children's book. But what it basically represents is Gaiman's art and his masterful skill of staying true to the myths of Norse mythology. Now, we know that in our culture, there are many different mythologies. We have Hindu mythology, Hawaiian mythology, Greek mythology. We have all sorts of mythologies that exist. All cultures have different forms of stories. And Norse mythology is just one type of mythology. It's a kind of mythology that you might not have heard of. But most of the people who haven't really heard of Norse mythology have actually heard of Thor. Thor, the Marvel character, Avengers 1 with the hammer, the strong character played by Chris Hemsworth, I guess. And that Thor, that character, is originally from Norse mythology. He's a Greek, he's a Norse god, and he's incredibly strong. And yet, not the wisest of gods, of course. He doesn't use his strength in the right way. He doesn't use his acumen to actually use his strength in the right direction. Now, Gaiman, using Norse mythology, tells you about the myths that have been passed on from generations to generations. They're heirlooms and they're myths that are unique, they're magical, they're whimsical, and he stays true to the actual myths. He doesn't change them. He doesn't shape them too much. All he does is that he tells those myths from the perspective of somebody living in today's day and age. He tells those myths from the perspective of a layman living in the 21st century, of course. Now, the next book that we have is Circe by Madeline Miller. Circe is a book that talks about the female. Again, this Circe as a book has a lot of similarities with the Palace of Illusions. There are a lot of stark similarities, even though Circe is from the Greek mythology, and I'll tell you why. Now, Circe as a character has a lot of similarities with the Panchali, as in the thing that Circe went through, the struggles that she has gone through. And the books are similar because this book again takes Circe, a side character, a rather neglected character in Greek mythology. Not very she's not talked about a lot. And there's a very, she's mentioned in passing in Greek mythology. The original tale by Homer and different philosophers doesn't really include a lot of things and a lot of stories about her. So what Madeline Miller has done is that she has made the main character Circe. The narrator of this book is Circe. She will carry the book forward. And she has tried to imagine what could have been Circe's story. She has tried to imagine what could have been Circe as a person, what could have been Circe as a goddess. Circe isn't actually a goddess. She was born to a god, the god of sun, Helios, but she was exiled to an island. And the woman who was exiled to an island, she had to live alone for so many years, and she had to have her own struggles. She discovered her talents on her own. She had a child on her own, and then Odessi again. She fell in love with Odessi. Odessi, the main character in the original tale, is now a side character, and that's why it's a feminist retelling yet again. A female character has been made the forbearer of the story and will carry the story forward. Now, Madeline Miller also takes a lot of creative privilege because Circe is a character that isn't talked about a lot in Greek mythology. So you have to imagine what could have been her story. So the story might not actually align a lot with the actual myth, but the main side characters, Penelope, Odysseus' wife, and other characters will definitely have a lot of similarities to the original tale. She hasn't changed the original characters. All she has done is she's expounded on and she's expatiated on Circe as a character, and she's imagined what could have been Circe. Now, the last book that we have chosen for the month that you will be polling for, of course, is The Song of Achilles, again by the same author, Madeline Miller. Now, The Song of Achilles is a beautiful story. It's a beautiful story about friendship and a bond, which hasn't been explicitly stated to be love. It is not love, because Homer, the writer, the philosopher who has written the original myth, has not explicitly stated whether it's love, whether it's friendship, or whether it's something more than friendship, whether it's a bond, whether it's a camaraderie, it's a bond homie. He hasn't mentioned whatever you want to call it. He hasn't labeled it. He has just carried the story forward as it is. तो होमर ने सॉन्ग ऑफ अकेलीस में क्या किया है, ही इज बेसिकली वो ग्रीक गॉड अकेलीस के बारे में बात कर रहा है, एंड ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट पेट्रोक्लस. पेट्रोक्लस इज अनदर मैन, एंड ही इज एन ऑकवर्ड यंग प्रिंस, व्हिच इज टू से दैट ही इज अ प्रिंस, ही इज नॉट अ गॉड, एंड ही हैज बीन एक्साइल्ड टू द कोर्ट ऑफ अकेलीस फादर. एंड अकेलीस as a strong god, Achilles as a man of power, as a man who's proven his mettle, a mettlesome, intrepid man, he doesn't necessarily match up with Patroclus much. He doesn't really have a lot of similarities with Patroclus. But yet, as fate has it, they have a very strong bond. They develop a strong bond as they move on with the story. And as the story goes on, Madeline Miller has stayed true. She has stayed true to the very story that the Song of Achilles is, and the story that the story of Achilles is, which is to say that she has not portrayed the bond between Achilles and Patroclus in any other way other than what the original myth told. She has she's made the story in such a way, she's crafted the story so masterfully that it stems from the deep-rooted bond between Achilles and Patroclus, and it stays true to the actual character. Now, these are the four books, and now I would like to enjoin you people, I would like to entreat you people to actually have a look at the form, to actually have a look at what all I have explained now. The PPT might be shared later on, of course. And moreover, I would entreat you people to kindly think about it, to kindly give it a thought, the idea of joining this family, and I'd be highly obliged for you people to join the family and for you people to become a part of the book club. It will be my pleasure to host you all. It will be my pleasure to learn from you all. It will be my pleasure to be with you all and to learn from your experiences, to learn from your viewpoint, and to get to know you as a person who thinks differently than me, of course, has a different perspective, a different viewpoint. And the Proffered Book Club essentially aims to do just that. It aims to make people love books, people who haven't read books before, people who are starting reading books, people who want to resume reading more, people who haven't read in a long time, or people who are ardent readers already. Voracious readers are welcome. Everybody's welcome. It's open to all. And I would be honored to host you people. And if you actually choose to join the book club, then please submit the forms by Sunday. I would again exhort you people to kindly submit the forms by Sunday so that we can have an idea. We can have an idea as to how many people are joining in. And then the team will be formed on Monday. The team containing all the members will be formed on Monday. And I will share the PDF of the book chosen in the form. That's why if you actually want to make a difference as to the kind of books that you, the book that you'll read, the book of the month, then you should vote before Sunday. So fill the form before Sunday, and then we'll make the team on Monday, and the book will be shared. And then by 20th July or the third week by the end of the third week of July, we will hold the discussion. And then from there onwards, you will be able to decide the genre, and we will be able to take the book club forward in a better way. Now, I would like to hand over the mic to Sangeeta ma'am. Thank you for this opportunity. And I would also like to thank Harmanjeet ma'am and Principal ma'am for this wonderful opportunity. And describing the kind of help that you've extended to me altruistically and the kind of help that you've extended to me selflessly, it would be beggaring for words. I'm very thankful for the kind of help that I've gotten, and I'll be forever beholden. Thank you.
Thank you, Purvank. For taking this initiative and bringing a platform for all of us where we can collaborate and share our reading experiences. You have also talked about the reading buddy, which is a good concept. So we are going to extend our family through this book club. That's also a good news for us. And we Sapiens, we really feel proud on you, because students like you keep bringing good ideas. And we, as the teacher or the staff of the school, it's our responsibility to take those ideas forward and make it a success. So I'm also hoping that many students and teachers and the family members join us, and we'll have good time discussing about these books. Thank you once again, Purvank. Now I would request Mrs. Anila Nayo, our principal ma'am, to address the attendees.
A very good afternoon to all of you. First, let me start by congratulating and appreciating the effort taken by Purvank. It's a wonderful thought, Purvank, and we very warmly welcome this initiative. This has been a thought for a long time, but it becomes more worthy when it comes from the students' end. Because the acceptance of such an idea should be from the person or the people who want to be involved more into reading. It should not be imposed. It should come with a lot of warmth. It should come with a lot of love for reading. Let me warn you that you will find very less members, because reading is not a hobby these days at all. The digital medium has so revolutionized our world that people have very less time for books. We are so glued to the screens. But I would like to even add that reading is not limited only to books these days. And that's the idea what you have brought in. That, okay, if it is digital, let's go to digital reading. Wonderful. So that thought and that effort is really appreciated. We would like to have similar ideas coming in. Again, as I told you, reading requires a lot of love for the letters. It requires a lot of love for a lot of patience also. But there is something which is very wonderful about reading. It connects with a lot of human emotions. When we read a story, when we read a mythological, whatever it is, whatever genre you are proposing, whatever book it is, there's a lot of emotions in those pages which are very, very much connecting to across ages. You have just mentioned a few books, but I'm sure these books are relevant in all ages, whether it is written at a time before we were born, whether it is a time even after, in the future, there will be emotions which will connect to human beings. And that's how reading becomes very, 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 very individualistic. It becomes very personal. So it is a very personal choice. And that is why I'm warning you, there will be very less people who are ready to get connected with books. So don't worry about the number of people in the book club. It may be, a few in number, but I'm sure the habit of reading is contagious. I have seen it in my own family. When there are members interested in reading, the others also find some taste in the books. Maybe they don't have the same taste for the genres. Some may like comics, some may like a little more adventurous books, some may like, suspense and thrillers. So the taste might be different, but when there are people who hold books in their hands, others do follow, try to find out what are they reading, and interest is created. So this initiative is definitely going to spread. It will create interest. It may take time, but I'm sure it will create a lot of interest. Today is a very important day. It is the death anniversary of P.N. Panikkar. He is the initiator, or rather, he's called as a father of the library movement in Kerala. He started with one library in the erstwhile Travancore, which is the name of the small principality before we got independence. With one library, it extended to almost 45 libraries by the time of independence. And by the time of his death, where he helmed the Kerala Granthashala for around 30 years and more, by the time the Kerala government took over the Granthashala Sankhatan, roughly translated into the Library Association, it was more than 6,000. Every village, every rural area had one small library with few books, but there was a library, and it spread the reading habits amongst people. And the research proves that the literacy rate, the high literacy rate that the state boasts of, has a lot to do with the contribution of P.N. Panikkar and the Library Association. Giving credit to that contribution, in 2017, the Honorable Prime Minister declared 19th June as the National Reading Day, and the thought of read and grow was spread from the small state of Kerala to across the country. CBSE also has taken the initiative to promote reading, because it is proven that reading is helping and supporting spreading literacy. I would welcome all the children who would be part of the reading club, the activities, the way in which Purvank has proposed. We have accepted it, having one meeting in a month, as he has proposed the last Saturday. And the children can discuss the books, what they have read and how they feel about the characters and what kind of qualities they have and what is the relevance of the book and what is the relevance of what they have read. So children read and grow. We would wholeheartedly welcome the teachers also to be part of it. And this initiative of having a reading buddy is wonderful. So even parents can be part. But as we have limited it to the MS Teams, you will have to read and join us through MS Teams through your ward's ID. So thank you, Purvang, for this great idea. And I hope and wish that it will grow into one of the best contributions of our student community towards the area of Baddi. Whatever we do in the school does never limit to the school. It always spreads to the society. And that way, your contribution should spread reading habits in and around Baddi. So thank you so much. Wonderful reading experience to all of you. I wish you so. And I also will be a part of the reading club as a member. I'm very excited to fill the form and join you. Thank you so much, Sangeeta and Dr. Harmanjeet, for being pillars of support for the students who take good initiatives and come across to implement them. We get a lot of suggestions from children. Let me add that point at this particular moment. But most of them are not practically possible. So when somebody comes with very practical ideas, we welcome them with a lot of warmth. So once again, thank you to all of you and also to our technical support provided by Saloni. As always, she helps us in moving across from one place to another digitally. So thank you, Saloni, for connecting and welcome aboard the Reading Club. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much. And good afternoon.